Honkai Star Rail was just launched on GeForce Now, but the game was already released on competitor cloud platforms Boosteroid and OnePlay. How does each stack up when playing Honkai Star Rail? Well, many of these platforms also have a number of different tiers. We'll be comparing the performance of 1080p 60fps tiers only, the GeForce Now Priority tier, OnePlay Enhanced, and Boosteroid Standard. These are the most popular paid tiers, which cost around $10 a month. Let's see which platform stacks up better. In this video, we'll be comparing these metrics for all platforms: graphics quality, FPS, stream quality, and I would have done latency, but it really doesn't matter in this game. First up, the GeForce Now Priority tier with graphics quality. The Priority tier is comprised of two different configurations, the RTX 2080 and the RTX 3060 configuration respectively, and you'll randomly get one or the other. Now on default, I get very high settings on both configurations. With Boosteroid, I get the exact same settings. Now what about OnePlay's Enhanced tier with the power of the RTX 4060? Yep, OnePlay defaulted to these settings as well. So each platform can hit very high settings with no issue. So there's no clear winner here. Let's call this a tie. Now on to FPS. Now here's the problem with this comparison. The game only allows 60 FPS max on default. These aren't modded versions of the game, so we can't unlock the FPS. Now this time we'll start with OnePlay. Their stat stream give me an FPS hovering right around 60. And no, I didn't have any deviations throughout my entire gameplay. Now what about Boosteroid? Well, their stream stats do not represent the in-game FPS, and the Epic Games app does not have an in-game FPS counter, so we can't tell what Boosteroid is running. Granted, Star Rail isn't a demanding game, so I'm gonna assume it's 60. Now how about the GeForce Now Priority tier? Again, the game is capped at 60 FPS, and GeForce Now has no problem hitting that and staying here, but take a look at the stats while in the menu. It's dying to go way past 60. Of course, this is just the menus, but it's an indication on how high the FPS might really go without the cap. Now who wins here? I'd say GeForce Now and OnePlay tie, and Boosteroid just loses out because we can't tell what the FPS actually is. Now onto the stream quality. I'm gonna put each up separately and then put all three up side by side, and you be the judge.
The truth of life and death, revealed in an instant. This sanctuary is but a vision. The truth of life and death, revealed in an instant. This sanctuary is but a vision. The truth of life and death, revealed in an instant. This sanctuary is but a vision. An instant. This sanctuary is but a vision.
I have to say, every platform plays this game very well, but GeForce Now seems to edge out its competitors with a crisp and smoothness that just seems cleaner than the others. Maybe I'm wrong. Did you see what I see? Let me know in the comments below. OnePlay comes in second, while Boosteroid comes in third, mainly just due to lack of stats. Overall, this was a very simple game to compare because this isn't a demanding game, and all three performed very well. I recommend playing Honkai Star Rail on any of these platforms if you have access. I'll put the links to the Getting Started videos with all these platforms in the description. For the next game I compare in this format, I'll have to choose a way more demanding game that all three platforms have. Maybe like Cyberpunk. Let me know what game you would like to see that is available on all three platforms. If you like this comparison video of Honkai Star Rail on GeForce Now, Boosteroid, and OnePlay, give us a like. Also, make sure to join as a member of the channel or join our Patreon and our Discord in the links below. And above all else, make sure to subscribe to keep it locked right here at the only place where you can do battle in gaming heaven, Cloud Gaming Battle.